हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम विकास शर्मा एंड वेलकम यू टू द वर्देता लर्निंग ट्यूटोरियल्स। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू कैन इंस्टॉल द रिएक्ट नेटिव फॉर डेवलपिंग द नेटिव एप्लीकेशन फॉर एंड्रॉयड। एंड देयर आर टू वेज टू डेवलप द एप्लीकेशन इन रिएक्ट नेटिव। वन इज एक्सपोज सीएलआई एंड अनदर वन इज नेटिव एप्लीकेशन थ्रू द रिएक्ट नेटिव क्लाइंट। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस फॉर द Android application. So it seems a typical to install and set up an environment to develop the React Native application, but I'm going to tell you in very easy steps how you can do it. Okay, so first of all I would like to tell you React Native, that is depending on three things. First is Node.js, then Python and JDK. Most of the people will be having JDK installed on their environment or on their system, but to install Python and Node.js we feel slightly having difficulties. So here we go. I am going to tell you how's the process to install it on the system, the better way, or I can say the best way to install all these things and set up a native application environment for React Native. So here we go. First of all, we need the Chocolaty install on your Windows. Windows, that is the installation manager for Windows nowadays, very popular in the developers. So before installing Chocolaty, you need the PowerShell on your system. So here I have provided the URLs in the description area of the video. You can get it very easily. So just click on these URLs and follow the path. So first of all, you have to install the PowerShell on your PC. That's very simple step to install PowerShell on your Windows app. And after installing the PowerShell, you have to run it in the administrator mode. If you install PowerShell, then it will be showing here as a PowerShell window. Okay, after installing the PowerShell, you will have to install the Chocolaty. Here is the URL to install the Chocolaty. If you follow this URL, then you will find that it's very simple to install the Chocolaty on your system. There is just a simple command that you can follow to install this on your system. Here also I have mentioned this command to install it on your system. So this is the exact command that you have to run on your PowerShell. Make sure that you run your PowerShell in the administration mode. So now just go to the PowerShell, right click, open run as administrator, flask you, then here you can run on your command to install the Chocolaty on your system. This command will do everything for you to install Chocolaty on your system. How to make sure that this command has done its work? Just write and it will show you the version of Chocolaty here. So now you have installed Chocolaty on your system and PowerShell already installed on your system. Now it's the work of Chocolaty installation manager to install the Node.js and Python and JDK for you. If you already have JDK installed on your system, then just remove this option from here, otherwise you can include it. Okay, if you have already installed Python and Node.js on your system, then it is advisable to remove them all that is already present on your system and let the Chocolaty install the Node.js and Python as per its requirement for React Native. Okay, so let's go to the next step, how to set up. After the installation of these three things, you will have to install or I would say you will have to set up the Android on your system so that you can build the React Native application for Android. So here comes the important things after the installation of this all these three things, you'll have to set up Android Studio for this. So you'll have to install Android SDK, Android SDK platform, Android virtual device, and Hyper-V also. If you haven't installed Hyper-V already on your system, then please do a Google search and install the Hyper-V on your system. That's not a very big deal. You can install it with some simple steps, and you will have to make some changes in your boot environment also to install it on your system. So that's important thing when you are testing your application on your system. Okay, so after installing all these three things, you will have to install Android SDK platform 29 and these two packages. Okay, so let's go and see how we can do it. You already have if you don't already have installed Android Studio on your system, then you can simply go and download and install this. But the important thing is I am going to tell you. Go to the file, go to the settings, and appearance, behavior, system setting, and then Android SDK. Here you will see this screen, but if you check it here, then you will see the other things. So on the Android 10.0Q, you have to check these two: Android SDK platform 29, Intel 86 Atom 64 system image. The these two things I have already mentioned here. So these are very necessary to install to run the application, React Native application, on your system. So as you can see, I have already checked and installed them on my system. So you can just go check and do the next in the very easy steps to install these two packages. Okay, after that, the next step is to add Android home environment variable on your system. If you check my system, I already have added it on my system. Let me show you how you can do it. Just go this PC, properties, advanced system setting, environment variable, and here you go. You can see this environment variable where I already added. So this is the path that need to be added on the Android home environment variable. And how you find out this path? Okay, let me show you. When you go to the C drive, users, your username, and then here you can see it might be not visible to you because you have not enabled the hidden item, so you cannot see the app data folder here. So this is the important thing you should remember: check on hidden items and then you can see the app data folder here. Go app data and local Android SDK. So here this is the path. You have to copy it and just paste it on the variables value. Okay, so this is necessary to add Android home. After that, the next step is to add the platform tools to your path variable. So here we go on to the path variable. If we edit it, I already have added it here. What you have to do, just go here, your SDK, there is platform tool folder, just double click it, copy it, and just add it to the path variable. I have already added it, you can see it here. So here it's done for environment variables. Okay, so now we are done with our environment setup. Now we are ready to initialize our application React Native. This is the command that we use to create, or I will say the initialize the application. So just go to the folder wherever you want to create your project. I have created in React project. Okay, this is my first project. Oh, So I'm going to open it into the command prompt, simple, and just I'm putting this command here and executing it. Don't worry, all of the commands and all of the things whatever I have mentioned here, I will attach all these things in the description area of this video. So don't worry, you will get all these things in your hands. Okay, so after running this command, you will see things are executing here, and after sometimes you will see a screen like that. If you see this screen, all things I have done, that means your project has been built. So I have already built one project, I can show you. See, after the initialization you can see multiple files here. You can import this project in your Android Studio and you can change it as per your requirement or form. Currently here it's blank, and after this execution or initialization you will see some files there in that folder. Okay, so friends, this is the whole process of setting up the environment for the React Native applications for Android. So it's done for today. That's it. You are ready to develop the React Native application for Android. So we'll see you in the next lecture.